Don't miss any content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about Nigerian player John Mikel Obi. He has made his move to Stoke City. I brought you a story between these two teams, Stoke City and West Bromwich Albion. Rumors were that he would join one of them. And finally, he has made the switch. I'll be giving you more details today. Frank Echampon has made history for Ghana. He becomes the first Ghanaian to ever captain a Chinese Super League side. And we all know we have a plethora of Ghanaians in the Chinese Super League, Emmanuel Boateng, and also recently Mubarak Wakaso. Frank Echampon becomes the very first man to ever captain a Chinese Super League side. And Bernard Mensah has completed his loan switch from Kayserispor to Beşiktaş in Turkey. As usual, if you're new to the channel, I advise you to subscribe to the channel and to click on the notification bell to get more updates. So we just jump right into it, and we all know the story of John Mikel Obi, the Nigerian former Chelsea player, AFCON winner, Champions League winner, and Premier League champion. He has joined the ranks of Stoke City in the Championship to help them push for a place in the Premier League next year. Stoke manager O'Neill was excited by the move for John Mikel Obi. He becomes the fourth signing for Stoke City this summer, and the club are delighted by that. Manager Michael O'Neill said, "We are delighted by the addition of Mikel Obi." Now, the Nigerian international midfielder joins Morgan Fox, James Chester, and Stephen Fletcher in checking in at the Bet365 Stadium ahead of the 2020-2021 championship season. Mikel won a host of trophies domestically and European for Chelsea during a glittering 11-year stay. He returns to English football after a spell with Turkish football Trabzonspor, which he ended by mutual consent, and it was because the team was playing due to the COVID-19 pandemic and he did not want to have a part of that. The world was bleeding and they were just going on as if nothing had happened. Eventually, Turkey stopped playing football and Mikel Obi by then had left, so he did not want a part of that. He said, Michael O'Neill said, "I'm really impressed with him when we met for the first time, and he outlined what he wants for the next phase of his career. We spent 4 hours talking, and he made it clear he wants to get back into the Premier League and finish his career there, and hopefully he can do that with Stoke City." Now, Mikel made more than 370 appearances for Chelsea, helping them to land the Premier League title twice, as well as 3 FA Cups, the Champions League and Europa League. After a spell in China, he played for Middlesbrough after joining them on a short-term deal in January 2019, making 19 appearances, scoring 1 goal. Has 91 caps before retiring from international football with the Super Eagles of Nigeria, and he played in last year's AFCON 2019. So Mikel Obi there joining Stoke City. Great news for him, great news for Stoke City. Some experience from the Nigerian hopefully will get them back into the Premier League. Let me know what you think in the comments box. Mikel Obi's move to Stoke City. I'm quite surprised by the move, but he is in the twilight of his career, still making good moves, and Stoke City will provide the next challenge for the Nigerian. Let me know what you think in the comments box. I move on to my next story. It has to do with Ghanaian player Frank Echampon. Now, Frank Echampon has made history for Ghana in the Chinese Super League. It's quite historic, but he becomes the first ever Ghanaian to captain a Chinese side. Now, Frank Echampon has been named captain of the Chinese Super League side Shenzhen Tada, becoming the first Ghanaian ever to captain a Super League side in China. Now, Echampon, who joined the Chinese club in 2017 of July on a 6-month loan spell, had a remarkable outing after scoring 9 times to safeguard their stay in the top flight. Now, Echampon's 17 goals tally in the 2018 season is the highest by a player in single season in the history of the club. The head coach decision to make the unstoppable winger the new captain is seen by fans of the club as a reward for his hard work, dedication, commitment, exceptional leadership skills, and most importantly, the quality he continues to demonstrate on the field. The 26-year-old takes up his challenge and who assumes his new role in the away game against Hebei CFF on Monday. Like he assumed that role on Monday. The club has made its worst start to the season since the champion joined Tether with 3 losses and a draw from opening 4 matches this season, just 1 point from a total of 12. But the new leader Achampong is poised to turn the fortunes of the team around. He said, "I'm particularly honored to be made the captain of this great club. It has come at a very challenging time when the club is struggling very early in the season. I hope that with collective efforts we can turn things around this season." He joined them in 2017, has made 56 appearances for them so far, and has directly contributed to 43 goals, scoring 26 and assisting 17. So Frank Echampong, historic move there by the Ghanaian, and he is now the captain, first ever Ghanaian to captain a Chinese side. Kudos to him. We hope he does well in the Chinese Super League. The worst possible start his team can ever get to. It's quite unfortunate, but hopefully with collective effort, as he said in a statement, they can get back to winning ways. Let me know what you think about Frank Echampong. Probably this might earn him a call-up into the Ghana Black Stars. You never know. It's anything is possible. So 26 years of age. And in the last call-up, the one that coach CK Akono mentioned, he was not in the squad for that occasion and he was not called up, and I hopefully he gets a chance to exhibit his talents with the Ghana Black Stars. But let me know what you think about Frank Echampong and his captainship, his possibility of joining the Ghana Black Stars. Should it be something CK Akono should be looking at? Let me know what you think in the comments box. I move on to my final story. It has to do with Ghanaian player and Turkish striker. He plays for Beşiktaş now, formerly of Kayserispor, Bernard Mensah. Now, Bernard Mensah finished last season with Kayserispor, who were set to be relegated. But because there is no relegation in the Chinese Super League, he went out on loan, however, to Beşiktaş, where Ghanaian player Kevin Prince Boateng was playing last season. Now, that move is going to cost Beşiktaş 500,000 euros for that loan move, and they will pay a further 4.5 million euros to make the move permanent at the end of the season. Now, the 25-year-old has joined the Black and White on a season-long loan with the option of making it permanent. Former Atletico Madrid player, Kayserispor player, arrived in Istanbul earlier on Monday to put the finishing touches on the move. He passed the mandatory medical before signing the contract. Bernard Mensah was not called up for the Ghana Black Stars in their recent outing, which Kosike Akono called up a fresh set of players, but he was not informed. So that has been it for today. Tonight we have the Champions League. PSG will take on RB Leipzig. Hope they can make it to the final, but Leipzig will not be any walkover. And from what we learned from them in the quarterfinals, they showed Atletico Madrid that they are no pushover side. Lyon will also face Bayern Munich on Wednesday. Sure to be an interesting set of fixtures to look forward to. And also, the Europa League final has been set. Inter Milan will be facing Sevilla in the final. Manchester United and also Shakhtar Donetsk could not make it into the final. They were beaten by Sevilla and Inter Milan respectively. So we'll be looking forward to that final, which will be over the weekend, I'm sure. The Champions League final is this weekend, 23rd of August. I will be streaming live. Watch along as I usually do. Hope the best team wins. Bayern Munich versus Lyon. Leipzig will take on PSG. Neymar and co looking to make history with PSG. Let me know how you think those fixtures will go in the comments box. I've been talking to you about Bernard Mensah's move, loan move to Beşiktaş. Also, Frank Echampong has made history for Ghana. He has become the first Ghanaian to captain a Chinese Super League side. I've also been talking to you about Kelobi's move to Stoke City. Let me know what you think in the comments box. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.